Ladies and gentlemen, let's get ready to rumble!
One of the faces on the circuit around England, and I believe one of the top coaches in England. I've said it to his face, and now I'm telling you, Ian Robinson. Liam, you've got a young man that I tipped for the top, very, very good fighter, Ricky Sewell. He's how old is he, 18?
18, yeah.
What's the secret? What's the secret with you? Because you've got some really, really good kids, is it? Is it grounded with Tony, or what is it for you?
Obviously, initially, all the training and everything is from what I've learned from Tony, and a little bit stuff modified here and there. A lot of it is from Tony. And another thing I think with the young lads is just a mutual trust thing between us. I mean, we enjoy our training, we get on with our training, we train hard. There's a lot of trust between me and the fighter. But they know if I put them in for a fight, that they're ready for it, and I expect them to make it. There's no doubt in their fight.
Yeah, that's good. It's a mindset that I know of job, as I do understand that. But it's a very important part. He said to me that you all have fun. Daniel McGowan, he's got Colin Coyle,
Coyle.
You've also got Panikos. Panikos is fighting very soon, isn't he, on the main event. He's in time at the moment. Tell us about what you've done with Panikos, because Panikos came from another division, didn't he?
Panikos came to me shortly after he fought Craig Warren. Just a bit of a strange story, actually. I bet a bit of money on him to win. I've seen a lot of his fights do it next Saturday. And he lost that fight just purely on clinch work. So he came to me really to learn a bit of clinch, and then we got on, and then his coach had moved away. From then on, really, I've just sort of always worked on him. We've worked on obvious parts of his technique, but mainly it's been his clinch work, which is one of his strong areas now, actually. He's won fights on his clinch work, whereas before it was way more than fights.
So you're making up the gaps where you've seen the gaps in their game, and you're starting to make up areas where they wasn't so good in.
That's it, yeah. If there is a weak area, I think that if an opponent sees that in a sport like this, they can close that down and they'll decide, oh, I'm only going to finish this fight. And you can't use them with a weapon, so no matter how long you're punching away, so you see them the time.
Well, to be honest, credit where credit's due, he's only a young man compared to me, and he's one of the, I believe, one of the emerging coaches in the country. He's done a really good job. I think good luck to that. I'll see you very soon.
Thank you very much. Cheers. Thanks, mate.